Today we are going to deal with tender documentation and the quality improvement of tender documentation. Preparation of tender documents. Projects are usually tenders among contractors who obtain a competitive price. All preparation of tender documents should be carried out very carefully. Individual client do give room for the post-tender negotiation and refine the tender values. Preparation of tender documents for government projects. All government projects, particularly high value ones, should undergo a value engineering exercise before these projects are regular. As these projects are regular occurrence and they do have the past experience with similar projects, and the same to be carried forward as a lesson learned to obtain the best value for money. Normal government projects such as school buildings, hospital buildings, roads, etc. to be well planned in advance and never hurried for projects. The concept in certain places where it is jokingly said that what the employer is asking today is actually wanted yesterday to be completely avoided. As I said before, all government contracts to be usually remeasured type with approximate quantities at tender, which are subject to remeasure upon completion, thus reducing the contractual risk, especially for contractor. Proper client briefing in order to avoid variation, time and cost of overruns. Proper ground investigation to determine the unique properties of the substructure for the proposed location. Completion of detailed design prior to the preparation of tender documents is very essential. Specification to cover the full scope of work. Check for the constructability prior to the introduction of innovative concepts, if any. Application of supply chain management and the freedom to use alternative materials locally available, meeting the specification to reduce the usage of long delivery items. Replace traditional methods with the latest technology and adapt value engineering as far as possible. Quality check of design. Anticipate the risk and mitigation of same at the tender documentation prior to dispatching to the contractor for pricing. Sufficient period with a minimum of 2 months to a maximum of 4 months to be given to consultant to do the design and prepare tender documentation. A minimum of 28 days to be given as tender period. The tenderers to be instructed not to make their own correction to the tender document. Any such correction or clarification that are required by the tenderers to be made in writing to the employer. The consultant shall prepare the answers or clarification, and the same is to be circulated to all the tenderers as notices to tenderers, and the same is part of the contract document. A preamble note stating that the event of dispute, notice to tenderers shall take precedence, is to be stated in the notice to tenderers to avoid conflict during the implementation of the project. Stamped and signed notices to tenderers to be submitted with the tender. Sometimes, government entities prepare lump sum contracts for certain projects in order to have certainty of the final price. They also prepare bill of quantities to provide a uniform basis for tender. As usual, the final price is fixed. There are no possibilities for correction for errors in the given bill of quantities. In such cases, items to be given in the bill of quantities for tenderers to make the necessary corrections and to include any item or items that are required to complete the works as per tender drawing specification and other requirements not already included in the tender document. The government entities will decide whether to go ahead with the project as it is or with reduced scope. all out at all within the 6 weeks of receipt of offers. Other type of contractual arrangement can be considered with the higher authority approvals for emergency works. Structure of a tender document. The tender document should have at least the following for the government-funded medium-sized projects, medium size and above the projects. Volume 1, tender and contract conditions. Volume 2, specifications, both general and particular specifications. Volume 3, bill of quantities. Volume 4, tender drawings. Volume 5, soil investigation reports. Tender and contract conditions. Tender details such as name, brief details of the project, along with the condition of contract should be given. Specifications. General and particular specifications regarding the quality of the work or the given in the bill of quantities. Approximate quantities of work to be done by the contractor to price. Tender drawings. Prepared in detail such as architectural, civil, structural, electrical, mechanical, ECT, etc. Along with the standard details. Bill of quantities should be reasonably accurate to form a uniform document. These tender drawings becomes the contract drawings after it is updated with the tender clarifications. Soil investigations. Soil investigations of the proposed site. This is an important contract document, particularly for claims pertaining to underground conditions. Pre-qualification of tenderers. Usually, contractors are pre-qualified work-wise and amount-wise, depending on the contractor resources. This is usually done annually. Tender analysis report. Government projects should be awarded only after a suitable analysis of tenders received for transparency and honesty. Projects should not be awarded on the basis of merely submitting the lowest bid. Quality improvement of tender documents. The ideal tender document, the tender situation is there should be no notices and other clarification during the tender period. That means that all the tenderers have clearly understood the project requirement. Since we are human, there are always possibility for errors and omissions in the tender documentation in spite of our best effort, and hence these clarification and notices have become part and parcel of the tender process. Upon submission of offers and the final decision is made regarding the award of the project, a contract document is prepared. Usually, in most contracts, the original tender document and other post-tender correspondence are complied and it becomes a contract document with signatures of the parties to the contract, with description of the project, the site location, and the tender price. During the implementation of the project, both the contractor and the consultant had to review the original tender documents, specification, and other correspondence in order to prepare the working drawings. This involves substantial items and effort, substantial time and effort, and this is primary reason for time overruns. The contract document should have at least the following for the government-funded projects. Volume 1, tender and contract condition. Volume 2, specification, both is general and particular. Volume 3, bill of quantities. Volume 4, tender drawings now become a contract drawings. Number 5, soil investigation reports. Post-tender correspondence. Suggestion to improve quality of tender documentation. The contract document preparation to commence from day 1 of the tender. The tender documents, such as drawing, specification, bill of quantities, should be regularly updated with reference to tender notices and other clarification. A log that we maintain regarding notice, clarification, other tender notices. This procedure shall ensure a finalized contract document which could be used for construction of at site and is ready at the time of submission of offers. This is a moral requirement on the part of the consultant, as the clarification by the tenderers are the result of errors and omissions in certain documents which were prepared by the same consultant. Only negotiation, if any, after submission of offers to be incorporated into the document for final signature by the parties to the contract. All contract documents to have original tender build up along with overhead and profit, reasonably approved by the employer. Provisional sums are considered to be prescription of the tender documentation. In other words, zero provisional sum is ideal, which indicates that the design is 100% complete. This is impossible to reach. Complete analysis of provisional sum to be done before the tender, and as far as possible to be included in the measured work. There is another difficulty in using these provisional sums. The employer do not get the competitive price like in the tendency. Provisional sums were limited around 5% of the tender price. This is another cost element for the employer in the form of main contractor's markup for provisional sums. Normally, main contractor gets this percentage addition without using additional resources or using very less insignificant resources. There are instances where service authority charges are included under provisional sum. This involves practically no additional input or coordination, only the coordination with the service authority is anyway part of the contractor's scope. Contractors are in receipt of markups. This can overcome by stating in the conditions of contract that no markup will be given where there is no subcontractor agreement. So, in other words, there is no subcontractor agreement with the government authorities and the contractor, then there is no markup is paid. It is not possible to have subcontractor agreement with service authorities. Small quantities intended. This is one of the smart contractors usually do this. Small quantities of work should be checked for possible additions by the execution. Contractors usually price high these items as it will not make any significant change in the tender price. They are likely to gain if there are additions in such items of works. Errors in the preparation of bill of quantities. Bill of quantities should be prepared carefully for remeasure projects. There is a possibility for smart contractors to doctor the rate, quoting high where likely additions and low where likely omissions. A check has to be done. Check whether the lowest at the tendering stage is still the lowest by a checkup. Has to be done when the project is completed to see whether the original lowest tender is still the lowest by incorporating the final quantities at the statement of completion instead of the tender. In theory, he is still to be the lowest. Otherwise, some kind of doctoring has taken place. All tenders must undergo this checkup. To make sure that tendering is properly done to secure the best price at the tender stage. In some cases, after tender submission, client may request the consultant to reduce the scope owing to budget and other constraints. This is not part of the duties of the consultant in the preparation of 10 documents. This involves several discussions with the selected contractor and the client. Therefore, the consultant has to be compensated for resources used in this exercise. The final consulting amount for this exercise cannot be more than 5% of the effected financial charges. To preserve the sanctity of the tendering system, no bids to be accepted after the official closing date of tenders. All government projects should be audited, possible correction for similar projects in the future. Thank you.